permutations part 3. In this video, I want to explain about the linear permutations and also circular permutations. Actually, there are two types of arrangements, means two types of permutations. One is a linear permutation and other one is a circular permutation. In part 1 and part 2, we already discussed about the linear permutations. In this video, some part is about the linear permutations on words, means letters, and some part is related to circular permutations. Now see first question. How many 5 different letter words can be formed by using the letters of the word consider? What is the word? Consider. What is the question? How many 5 different letter words? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 different letter words can be formed by using the letters of the word consider. What is the condition? See first question. So that how many of them begin with C? Begin with C means C position is here. So one letter of these letters is fixed. At first position there is a letter C. Because the question is how many of them begin with the C. Totally how many letters present in this word? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Total number of letters in this word? 8. C is fixed here. How many places remaining? 4 places remaining. And how many letters remaining? 7 letters remaining. So, there are 7 letters remaining and here 4 places remaining. So, arrangement is 7P4. We can arrange the letters of the word consider. Those words starts with the letter C in how many ways? 7P4 ways. See second sub question. How many end with R? Same. 5 letter words. How many end with R? R position is here. How many places are there? 4 places. Remaining letters are the 7. So, 7P4. Same. We can arrange in 7P4 ways. Next, see third one. How many begin with C and end with R? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many begin with C and end with R? So, 2 letters of these 8 letters are fixed. So, what are the remaining places? 3 places. How many letters are remaining? 8 minus 2 means 6. 6 letters are remaining and 3 places are remaining. So answer is 6P3. 6P3 words can be formed. Those words start with C and end with R. Now see second question. 4 brothers and 3 sisters are to be arranged in a row. 4 brothers and 3 sisters. Total how many members? 4 plus 3, 7 members. What is the first question? In how many ways they can be arranged? 7 members are there. We can arrange these members in a row in how many ways? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 7 places and 7 members. We can place, we can arrange these 7 members in these 7 places in a row in 7P7 ways. 7P7 is nothing but what? 7 factorial, 7 factorial ways. This is first sub question. Now see second sub question. All brothers sit together. All brothers sit together. How many brothers are there? 4 brothers. So, all brothers sit together. First, suppose B1, B2, B3, B4. These 4 members are one unit. So, 4 brothers take one unit. 4 brothers, one unit. Because all brothers sit together. together. So remaining members are three sisters. Three sisters plus one unit. Total how many members? Four. Three sisters plus one unit is equal to four. Total four. We can arrange these four members in four factorial ways. And four brothers are one unit. Means these four brothers can arrange themselves in how many ways? Four factorial ways. Means here B1, B2, B3 and B4. These four members can be arranged in four factorial different ways. For suppose B2, B1, B3, B4. Another one is B3, B1, B2, B4. Like that, arrangement is in a four factorial ways. So final answer for the second question is 4 factorial into 4 factorial. Now third sub question. All girls sit together. All girls means three sisters. Three girls sit together. So three sisters are one unit. Four boys plus this is one unit. So total 5. Total 5. In how many ways we can arrange these people? In 5 factorial ways. And here these three sisters are one unit. Three sisters, three girls can be placed themselves in how many ways? In 3 factorial ways. So final answer is 5 factorial into 3 factorial. Coming to fourth question, fourth sub question. No two sisters sit together. No two sisters sit together means first of all arrange boys or brothers in a row. So B1, for suppose here B, again B, again B, again B. Brothers. Okay. First of all place brothers, then here in between these brothers, how many places are there? 1, 2, 3 and end. 4, this beginning. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can place sisters in these places. No two sisters sit together. So, we can place a sister here, 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 here and here. We can arrange these four boys in how many ways? 4 factorial ways. And there are how many chances to place sisters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, places are 5 and how many sisters are there? 3 sisters. So, 5P3. 4 factorial into 5P3 is the result. Now, fifth question. No two brothers sit together. So, first of all, place 3 sisters in a row. Sisters, 1, 2, 3, S1, S2, S3, 3 places, 3 sisters. Now place brothers. How many places are there to place any brother? 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, 3 sisters can be placed in 3 factorial ways into 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 places to place a brother. There are 4 brothers and 4 places. So 4P4. 4P4. That implies 3 factorial into 4P4 is nothing but 4 factorial. And next one is 6th question. Brothers and sisters sit alternatively. Brothers and sisters sit alternatively. So first of all, I want to place a brother, then sister. Brother, sister, brother, sister, brother. See, how many brothers are there? 4 brothers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And how many sisters are there? 3 sisters. 1, 2, 3. Okay. This is possible. And what is the result? How many ways we can arrange like this? How many brothers are there? 4 brothers. So, 4 factorial ways. And 3 sisters into 3 factorial. Starts with sister. S. Brother. S. B. S. B. Then S, B. Sister, brother, sister, brother, sister, brother. If I place S here, that is wrong because how many sisters are there? Only 3 sisters. 1, 2, 3. 3 sisters are completed. So there is no chance to place S here. there is a one more brother. Three brothers completed, there is one more brother. So B, this is not possible because question is brothers and sisters, is it alternatively? So this is not correct. So take this and answer is 4 factorial into 3 factorial. See third question, the number of ways in which 6 boys and 6 girls can be seated in a row for a photograph so that no 2 girls sit together is. Try to solve this question and write your answer in comment section. Now coming to circular permutation. What is the concept? Circular permutation. Linear arrangement or linear permutation is completed in part 1, part 2 and some part of part 3. Now see circular permutation. What is the difference in between linear permutation and a circular permutation? The things or people arranged in a row, that is called linear permutation. The people are placed around a circle is called a circular permutation. Yes or no? Let me explain with one example. There are 4 persons. Arrange 4 persons in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 places. We can arrange these 4 persons in these 4 places in a row in how many ways? In 4 factorial ways. Yes or no? Yes. Coming to circular permutation, this is a circle. First person, second person, third person and fourth person. In how many ways we can arrange these 4 persons in a circle? What is the answer? Is it 4 factorial? No, this is wrong. There is a difference in between linear arrangement and the arrangement in a circle. Now see, what is the difference in between these two? Actually, the answer for this is 3 factorial, not 4 factorial. N persons or N people or N things placed in a fixed circle in N minus 1 factorial ways. So here 4 persons, 4 minus 1 means 3 factorial ways. Why? Let me explain why. Now see 4 persons in a row. For suppose those 4 persons are A, B, C and D. This is one arrangement. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 places. Now I want to place this A in this place. I want to shift this person at second place. So here A, now here B, here C and here D. Next arrangement is, now I want to place this A here. A, B, C, D. Next arrangement is A, B, C, D. These are 4 different arrangements. According to the person A. A is placed at next place, next place, next place, etc. Now same thing in a circle. See here, A is here, B, C and D. This is one arrangement. And this is another circle. Now I want to move this A to this place. Suppose A placed here next B, C and D. Now another one is A, B, C, D. Next, another circle is here A, B, C, D. Here there are 4 possible ways and here see 4 possible diagrams. What is the difference in between these two circular and linear arrangements? In this linear arrangements, these are different. Means A is placed at first position and here at second place and here at third place and here at fourth place. These are different arrangements. But coming to circular arrangements, all these are same. ABCD. Because in circle there is no starting point. But suppose A is fixed here. From the point of A, at left there is a person, and at right there is another person, at front there is another person. Again, coming to this circle, see, A is fixed here. At front there is a C, at left B, at right D. Again, same. In this circle also same. But here not same, different. So in the point of a circle, all these are same. So first person, we can arrange the first person. Here there are how many members? Four persons. First person, four ways. We can arrange first person in four ways. Means any one of these four places. One place is different from other place in linear arrangement. But coming to circular permutation, if you want to place a first person, not four ways. Here not four ways, only one way. We can place the first person in only one way, not in four ways, because in circle there is no starting point. And the relative positions are same. In circular permutation, you should fix one member. After fixing of a particular member, then positions of other members are different. Now the fix A is a fixed. From the point of A, there are two persons. One is at left, another one is at right, and one more person is at front. Now second person, first person is only one way, not four ways. Second person, take second person. To place a second person, but suppose I want to place a second person here. Okay, B is fixed in this position. At right of B there is a person A, and at left there is some other person. At front there is some other person. First suppose I fix B here, then at right there is A. If I fix B here, at left there is A. If I fix B here, at right there is A. Okay, this place is different from this place, not same. But in the point of A, all are same. Because there is no starting point, A can place anywhere. Already A is placed here, so for B positions are different. So this place is different from this place. Means we can place B here, here, here. There are three different ways. So here second person B can place in how many ways? Three ways. But suppose B is fixed here. Now third person. Third person can be placed any one of these two places. So two ways. And fourth person. Fourth person in only one way. So here 3 into 2 into 1 means what is the result? 3 factorial. Here n value is 4, 4 members. And final answer is 3 factorial, means n minus 1 factorial. We can arrange n different things in a circle arrangement in n minus 1 factorial ways. You can simply remember the formula, means n minus 1 factorial in a circular arrangement and n factorial in linear arrangement. But understanding the concept is very important. That's why I have explained it like this. Finally, n people can be arranged in a row in n factorial ways, and n people can be arranged in a circle in n minus 1 factorial ways. Because in circular arrangement, we need to fix one person. That person is a reference point. In circular arrangement, in circle, there is no starting point. So one person is fixed and remaining n minus 1 persons are placed in remaining n minus 1 slots. In how many ways? In n minus 1 factorial ways. Now in circular permutation, one more important point is clockwise and anti-clockwise directions. Here A, B, C and D. Take in clockwise direction A, B, C, D. I want to reverse this, means left, right and right, left. Here A, here B, here C and here D. Okay. Now take in this direction, in anti-clockwise direction. Now see A, B, C, D. In clockwise direction A, B, C, D and in anti-clockwise direction also A, B, C, D after reverse. This is example for garland, garland or necklace or chain. But suppose take a garland. This is a garland. Now I want to reverse this. After reversing, we get same thing. Yes or no? In that case, there are duplicate permutations. There are duplicate permutations. So, in the case of garland or necklace, the formula of arrangements, n things arranged in a garland or necklace is n minus 1 factorial by 2. This 2 is for to remove duplication. Okay. Here A, B, C, D clockwise direction, in anti-clockwise direction. So there are 2 things same. That means that is a duplication. To remove that duplication in the case of a garland, take the formula n minus 1 factorial by 2. Now see first question in circular permutations. In how many ways 7 gents and 4 ladies be arranged around a circular table? 7 gents and 4 ladies can be arranged around a circular table. How many members are there totally? 7 gents and 4 ladies means here total 11 members. We can arrange these 11 members in a circular table in how many ways? N minus 1 factorial ways. Here n is 11 and formula is n minus 1 factorial. So 11 minus 1 factorial ways, 10 factorial ways. Now see second question. All ladies sit together. All ladies means how many ladies are present? 4 ladies. All ladies sit together means 4 ladies consider as one unit. How many gents are present? 7 gents. So 7 gents plus 1 unit equal to totally how many members? 8 members. But place these 8 members in a circular arrangement. So this is n here. Circular arrangement means n minus 1 factorial. So 8 minus 1 factorial, that equal to 7 factorial. Okay. This is not final answer. See 7 factorial and 4 ladies consider as one unit because all ladies sit together. These 4 ladies arranged in 4 factorial ways. So into 4 factorial. Don't take 4 minus 1, 3 factorial. Already here n is 8 members. So n minus 1 factorial ways, we already arranged in 7 factorial ways. 4 ladies treated as one unit. So these 4 ladies, 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are placed in a circle. Okay, in a circle. All these are placed themselves in how many ways? In 4 factorial ways. So final answer is 7 factorial into 4 factorial. See third question, third sub question. No 2 ladies wish to sit together. Totally how many members are there? 7 gents and 4 ladies. Here question is, note 2 ladies wish to sit together. Means first of all, arrange these 7 gents in a circle. So this is a circle and 7 gents. G1, G2, G3, G4, G5, G6 and G7. 7 members are placed in this circle. Among these 7 members, one member is fixed. That person is a reference point for remaining persons. So we should subtract one member from these members. So here 7 is n. N minus 1 means 6. We can arrange these 7 members, 7 gents in how many ways? 6 factorial ways. Okay, here question is, note 2 ladies wish to sit together. We can place ladies in between gents. So this is place 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. We can place these 4 ladies in these 7 places, in between these gents. So 7 places are there, 4 ladies are there. 7P4. 6 factorial into 7P4 is the final answer. I hope you understand all these questions very clearly. Still, if you have any doubt, let me know in the comment section. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.